Hi, my name is William Orving. I'm working as a technical artist here on Epic Games. If you followed my earlier tutorial, you should know how to activate the Pixel String plugin and how to package the application as a Windows executable. Now, the signaling web server folder that you see here on the bottom left is what is included. If you activate the run batch that I showed you in the later tutorial, you will open the default signaling server, which is here on the bottom right. In the top right, I'm using a web browser. It's a Chrome web browser that supports WebRTC, which is needed for interacting and using pixel streaming at all. And here on the top left is the application itself. So you'll notice that if I interact with this, and if I use my mouse cursor to change the camera angle, it also changes the application itself. And I can do that the other way around. Now, this is great for sharing your application with Pixel Streaming locally, but we had a lot of requests on Epic where people want to be able to share this to other networks and be able to, for example, show their applications to their clients without having to send the entire application to them. Now, this tutorial here is where I will show it to you. It's quite easy to set up, so let's get started. So just to get started, you'll have to understand that we need the public IP of your network to actually be able to share it later in this tutorial. What you can do is just go into any web browser. I'm using Chrome, and type what's my IP, and that will actually show you usually what your public IP address is. If it's not shown here, there is this website that should be probably the first thing you see here, which you can enter, which is called whatsmyipaddress.com, and then you will see the IPv4 IP address up in the top. Just wanted to be extra clear and show you the website for forwarding your port for Pixel Streaming. We're running it on your local computer. Here is a list of all the routers and how to set it up. So, if you were to run this on an AWS server, you would just need to run this runaws.batch file, and it should work automatically. Now, if you try doing this on your local computer, let's try it. Take some time to load. And when it's done loading, you'll notice that your IP, if you put it in your browser, this Pixel Streaming website will start. So an issue that a lot of users are having, including myself, is that if you use the runaws.batch file on your computer and you press this click to start with the application running, you'll notice that it gets stuck in starting connection to server, please wait. So the reason for us getting our public IP is for this reason. So what you could do, or what I tend to do, is just double click to start AWS signaling server. And you'll notice that there's a part called peer connection options with a small variable called public IP. Now, what you need to do is copy your IP or your public IP and put it instead of the public IP variable. Just remove everything else but the numbers, and put it in a double quote and save the file. Now you should be able to close this down. You should be able to run this again. Take some time to load. And when it's loaded, you can enter your IP again in your browser. It will open the website and now you will be able to run it. Now this looks like the local application that we shown before, but you can try this on other networks outside of your own and it should work fine. If it doesn't, there are probably firewall issues, and I will just show you after this clip how to disable that. So there are a couple of ways of disabling your firewall. The easiest is just pressing the Windows button on your keyboard and searching for firewall. Choose the first option and go under firewall and security, or network security, I think this is called in English. And then just disable the networks that you need to disable for it to run. I just tend to, for testing purposes, I tend to just disable all of them. While just disabling the firewall is the easiest method of trying if pixel screen works at all, it is recommended to still have the firewall protecting your computer while just opening the ports. You can do so by pressing the Windows key, searching for firewall, choose the same first option, go under firewall and network security, and go under the advanced setting. Now you'll notice there's some options here. I think in English it's inbound and outbound traffic, or inbound rules and outbound rules. Choose the inbound rules and select a new rule. Select the port. Click next. Now we will be doing this for both TCP and UDP, but we'll start off with TCP. And it's the 80 and 8888 ports that we want to open. Click next, accept it. I tend to do it for all, and just name it something like pixel streaming TCP. And then you want to do it the same for the UDP rule. Now when you run the run AWS batch file, it should work as intended. Like this.